Book of St. Matthew, please. Chapter 14. Glad you came out this morning. Glad to see you. We do need that. And I got to thank you. Appreciate that. And we're just glad you came out. Macon has about 400 churches, if you all know that. You decided to come here, and I thank you for that. Been praying for you throughout the week. We're just glad you are. You made our whole week by coming out. Matthew, please, chapter 14. And he said, come. And when Peter was come down, 29, out of the ship, he walked on the water
to go to Jesus.
Beyond.
But when he saw the wind boisterous,
yes,
he was afraid. And beginning to sink, he cried, saying, Lord,
save me.
And immediately Jesus stretched forth his hand and caught him said unto him, O thou of little faith, wherefore didst thou doubt? And when they were come into the ship, the wind ceased.
Thank the Lord.
Then they that were in the ship came.
Thank you. Dear one, we know the story, of course. You've heard over and over again how Peter was in the ship and he desired to come to Jesus. That was his motivation. This morning, take these next 8 minutes or so. Let me borrow your imagination. And let's put us in a ship. The ship was about 18 feet long and about 5.5 foot wide. So us, I wanted to sit almost in twos. And that'd be all right. No motor, you had to row the ship. And that'd be tough enough. How many here ever rowed a boat before? Only me, that's work. It's work, it really is. Especially going against the current. But it was at night during a storm. Different story now. Because you really can't see where you are, and the winds were contrary, coming over the boat. How many of you have been to a storm on a lake in a boat before? I have, and it is terrifying. Literally. And it was at night. No engine, rain, wind, whipping, and Christ was not there. Dark, people afraid. It was terror. But they begin to see Christ right there.
Right.
And Peter had a mind to want to come closer to Jesus. The song says, just a closer walk with Jesus.
Yeah.
And you know, wherever we live, in Africa, Zaire, Atlanta, California, all men need to be a closer walk with Jesus. Did you all know that?
Yeah.
That's the need. Now, they may not sense that. They may not know that. But that's what men need. Yeah. Imagine with me if all 7 billion people on the earth got saved for 2 weeks. What would you think?
My Lord.
Just 2 weeks.
Real saved, my Lord.
7 billion people in the earth for 2 weeks. Brother, prisons would be empty, jails would be empty, bars would be empty, and would be a heaven almost on earth.
Hospitals.
So all men need a little bit closer walk with Christ.
Yes, yeah, we do. Come on.
You may not know it. May not be able to sense it. But that's what the peace is.
True.
He said, thou wilt keep him in what? Perfect peace.
Perfect peace.
Mind to stay on thee. Around Christ is deliverance. Boldness. Activities, blessings, inspiration, and healing. And those are all good things you and I need this morning.
Amen. Amen.
But dear one, to get close to walk, he had to surmount some things. And you notice, when you go for God, the devil is always there. Isn't that right?
Yes.
He knew her to be the right time.
That's right.
So Peter had to get out of the boat.
Yes, he did.
Maybe you are in a secure position, but no. To get near to Christ, you got to come out of the boat. You got to come out of it. You can't stay in there and have Christ too. If you want to be near him or near them, you got to come out of the boat.
That's right.
Number two, you have to get past the storm. And you know, friends, I know a crowd this size. Some are in the midst of a storm.
Yes, sir.
A storm of wind, rain, it might be almost like a tornado, but you are in the midst of that storm.
Amen.
And the storm ought to keep you from Jesus.
Yes.
But don't let that storm keep you from Jesus.
Amen.
Come to him, all that are heavy laden, and I will give you what? Rest.
Rest, brother.
Rest. And sometimes, everyone, we need rest, as you all know that.
Amen. Amen. Yes, sir.
I have a tendency to overcommit myself. Some of y'all know that. And sometimes I get so tired, I just can't do anything.
Yeah.
My body tells me, you're doing too much, man. And my mind is affected because I'm overcommitting myself. And I got to do what? Learn to do what? Rest!
Yeah.
Rest!
Yeah.
Especially speaking of the spirit. Brother, we got to rest only in Christ.
Yeah, right.
Not in a boyfriend, girlfriend, authority, counseling. Only Christ has that perfect peace, perfect rest.
Yeah.
That's all understanding. Keep your hearts and minds like Jesus. So yes, he had to get past the storm, what he saw. Howling winds running around and just moving. Had to get past that to come to Jesus. And the wind, maybe some false doctrine, some false things you've heard. Don't let that keep you from coming to Jesus.
Amen.
You know, there was a storm in Florida, and winds were 120 miles an hour, can you believe
that?
I mean, that, the power that wind can drive waves, because see, wind, the waves, because of the wind. Some people, brother, are being driven almost insane, understand that? Pulled this way, pulled it, almost pulled apart through pressure.
My Lord.
This world, yes. Family, friends, church folks, whoever, being pulled apart.
True.
Come to Jesus. Come to
Amen.
Jesus.
Amen.
Or come at least nearer. Take one step, then got near to him.
Amen.
And of course, he had to get past his friends. They were in the boat. They might have said, Peter, that's water. Gravity cannot allow that. Peter, you know, last time you, Peter. He said, no.
Yeah.
If that be Christ, Lord, bid me to come to you.
Yeah.
Not you come to me, me come to you.
Yeah.
And he said, do what?
Come.
Had to get past the boat, storm, the wind, friends. Sometimes friends can hold you up.
Yeah.
They can also do what? Put you down.
Yeah.
Sometimes friends can help you forward and also push you back.
Right.
I told one guy, well, Brother Moon, you know, what will people say? I said, look, man, people will kiss you on your forehead and put a knife in your back at the same time. You know that. People can be cold.
Yeah.
There was one young man in Warner Robins. He's in court now. The judge broke him down during the session. He said, well, why did you kill that boy? Why did you kill that man? He said, Judge, in his tears, he said, I want to see how it feels to kill somebody.
Mm.
His best friend. Mm. But people can be cold these days.
Yeah.
Unfeeling. Unsensitive. And also the last thing, Peter had to get past gravity. He knew that if you walk water, you're gonna sink.
True.
He knew that, the fisherman. And he knew science, he was sure to go down. Had to get past that. Then when the world is pulling so hard, lust of the flesh. What else?
Lust of the
eyes. What else?
Pride of life.
Pulling.
True.
Somebody being pulled so hard.
True.
They trying to. Amen.
Bless
you. Anybody? Come here, brother. Come here a minute. Come here. Now, let's say this is the altar of God where I can get saved.
Amen.
But the devil, he got him pulled the other way.
True.
Don't put my butt up now. Pulled the other way. It's all right. And they try to take one step forward and go one step back.
That's
They try again. Never what? Pull them away. They try again. Be what? Pull them away. And one day they're going to die. It'll be too late.
Yes, it is.
The pool will be over. But they won't pull that again. What you do is like this. Say, devil, take the coat. I'm gone.
Amen.
Not this or that, but to have a closer walk with Christ.